Hey guys. Oh, that's my doggy. Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Savannah, and today I'm going to be talking all about the brand called Elf. And I'm sure a lot of you guys have heard about Elf, but it's a makeup brand that stands for eyes, lips, face. They're really cheap makeup products, but they're also a lot of the times quality makeup products. So that's why Elf is so popular. You can buy Elf at Target or you can also buy it online. So I'm gonna start off with my hits. And this one is the Elf High Definition Powder. So I got it in the color Sheer. I'm not sure if there are any colors, but anyways, I'm pretty sure this retails for $6 and you just screw off the cap like that, and then it comes with a little powder puff, and then the product is in there, and it's actually a white powder that you put all over your face to set your makeup, and it truly gives you a matte finish, like a very, very matte finish. I don't have another powder that makes my face look so matte, so if you have really oily skin or you just want an overall matte look, I definitely recommend this powder, and I know a lot of other people like it as well. And it's $6, which is more expensive than a lot of the e.l.f. products, but I mean, $6 isn't that expensive. Like, that is a pretty good deal considering powders like this can run up to, I don't know, $50, $60. So this is definitely a try. So the next hit I have is the e.l.f. Mineral Infused Face Primer. And this again is $6, so it is more expensive. And I actually got it in the color green because I have pretty bad skin. And when you use a green primer, it counteracts with the red, so it just takes down the redness before you put your makeup on. I really like this primer overall. It just comes with a pump there. Mine is actually all out, so I've just kind of been like scraping the insides for it. But yeah, I would say overall this is a really good primer. It's $6, which is cheaper than any other primer that I really know of that is actually good. Face primers can be really expensive, definitely at least $20. So I think that this is a must-have, and especially if you have really red skin or acne. So I think that this is really good to put on your skin before putting on your makeup. Okay, so another hit that I have is the e.l.f. Eyebrow Kit, and this just comes with a gel and a powder, and I've actually been using the gel quite a bit for my brows, and I didn't realize that I think you're actually supposed to use the powder first and then set it with gel, but if you're just getting started out with doing your eyebrows, I highly, highly recommend this because it is only $3, and I think that it gets the job done. I got it in the color light, so I think that there's three shades, I could be wrong about that, but yeah, so although that this color looks really light, it comes across as dark when you actually put it on your brows, so I really like this, and I definitely recommend it to anyone who wants to start off filling out their brows, because it's really cheap, and it's a good product. Okay, so the next product that I like is the Lip Exfoliator. Sorry, I don't know why there was a big pause between that, but yeah, I just want to start off by saying that this smells absolutely amazing. I want to say kind of like coconut cocoa, but it does like feel rough when you put it on, but it's exfoliating your lips, so it's supposed to feel like that. And I honestly really like this product, especially if you're going to compare it to the lip scrub by Lush. I've never tried that, but I mean, that is very expensive, and I think that this is only like $1 or $3, so it's quite cheap, so I definitely recommend this. So another e.l.f. product that I recommend are the e.l.f. cream liners, and I just have them in black and plum, I think it is. So that's what that looks like. I've had it for quite a while. Products like these do tend to dry out, but I honestly haven't had a problem with it. I will say that it smudges a little bit, but I feel like the color payoff is kind of like, bam, like it's really dark. Not necessarily in your face, but I think it has a really nice color payoff, and I just really like the overall look of the eyeliner. So I have the black one, and then I also have the one in plum, I think it is. So that's just a purple. So that's really nice if you have green eyes. And I just really like the color a lot. Okay, so this is a product that I'm kind of on the fence about. This is a Zit Zapper. I have really problematic skin, so this might be not enough for me. I find it helps a little bit. I feel like I haven't actually tried it enough to know for sure, but it's only 99 cents, so I'd recommend trying it if you don't have too bad acne. If you just have pimples here and there, I recommend trying it because it's only 99 cents. This product is on the fence about this one too. It's the Makeup Mist and Set with Aloe Green Tea Cucumber and Vitamins A, C, and E. So yeah, you just kind of squirt this all over your face after you've done your makeup to set it. But I will say though that this makes my makeup like just really, really wet in comparison to the MAC Studio Fix, I think it's called, which is just kind of like a light mist. This I find is just kind of like really wet all over my face, and I find that it gets used up quite quickly because I honestly haven't used it that much and it's almost halfway done. So yeah, I mean, like, if you want to try out a makeup mist because it is cheaper, I would suggest this. I wouldn't say it's the best makeup mist though. Okay, so now for misses. This is a mineral eyeshadow primer. It's only 99 cents, but it honestly doesn't do that much, so yeah. Another miss is the concealer, pencil, and brush. This concealer, I put it on, it hurts so much. I don't like it at all. It's just not very soft. And then it just has like a little blending brush here, but I think that this is pretty much garbage and I don't recommend this. And then the next one is eyebrow lifter and filler. Just in comparison to the duo with the gel and the eyeshadow, I don't think that this is very good. I just don't really like eyebrow pens or pencils as much because I find that they're too harsh sometimes. But if you want a harsh eyebrow look, then maybe try this out because it is cheap, but wasn't wowed by this. And then the last miss I have are these three eyeliners, and these are the shimmer eyeliner pencils. So I got them in gray, green, and purple, and I'll just do them on my hand here. But they're just pretty. They're honestly just very dull and they smudge. I'm just not like a fan of them. I don't know. They kind of look like they're showing up better on the thing there, but they just seem like really super dull. I'll zoom in here so it's more accurate, but they're just kind of dull. I don't really like them that much. So that's all my hits and misses, and I hope that you guys enjoyed this video and it gave you a better sense of what to buy from e.l.f. So yeah, I hope that you guys have a great day and I'll see you later. Bye!